Hekia parata.
Tēnā koe te mana whakawā, huri noi tō tātou whare, tēnei ahiahi, tēnā tātou katoa. Thank you for the opportunity to stand and make a contribution on the social assistance, new work tests, incentives and obligations amendment bill. I'd like to start by complimenting the Minister who has had to depart the House, because as speakers from both sides of the House this afternoon have commented that any debate on social welfare will be fraught with emotion, as it should be. It will be fraught with quite oppositional views on it, and it is not an easy area to change or bring reform to, and the Minister has had the courage to do that while also putting up with insults as she goes about her work. So I would like to commend her courage in leading work on the reform of this part of the social welfare system. What it reflects, as colleagues on this side of the House have said, is a campaign commitment that we made to reform the social welfare system as part of the context of a culture of aspiration. We do not think that a life on a benefit is any life at all. We think that the opportunity for New Zealanders to get into work, to be able to earn an income, to be able to model to their children the norm of going out and participating in society, of contributing to the workforce, is something that we are is aspirational and that we want for all New Zealanders. Being in work is something that I think we underestimate the contribution of to homes that otherwise have been completely dependent on a benefit. And dependency is a disease. I make no apology about stating it as starkly as that. Dependency on the state gives no life to the family or to generations of family who find themselves trapped in a two-week horizon. That is not the kind of life that I foresee as being well for my whānau, for the communities I've been part and parcel of, or for communities across New Zealand. As I've said, life on a benefit is no life at all. My colleague from the Māori Party, Te Uruoro Flavel, made reference to some wonderful composers, Tuini Ngāwai and Āpiranga Ngata, whose songs and whose poetry and whose narratives tell us how important that it is that we have no dependence on benefits. And they talk about them in comparison to the devil. That is the kind of linkage that our forebears have made in exhorting us not to be dependent on the state in any way, shape or form. What this bill reflects is a principle of reciprocity. Yes, we are committed to a caring and compassionate state. We are committed to helping those who are unable to help themselves. And we are equally committed to respecting and honouring those people who are in work, whose taxes contribute, who fund our compassion. We see that this principle of reciprocity must be applied evenly. If we ask New Zealanders to give as we do, then those who are getting have an obligation to do as much as they can to move themselves into that category of giving. So I again support absolutely the reciprocal obligations that we are seeking here. What is wrong with work testing a parent, be it a mother or a father, whose child reaches the age of six? The horror with which this seems to have been greeted by that side of the House pays no respect to those parents who have children who are six or older, or indeed younger, who are in the workforce already, and through whose taxes they are assisting those who are not. So let's be fair, it shouldn't really matter whether or not you are on a benefit or not. If you have a child who is six or older, I think it is totally appropriate to apply a work test to see whether or not those people can rejoin the workforce. Again, I point to the fact that this side of the House is committed to the idea that all New Zealanders have the opportunity to be in work. I don't see what's wrong at all with having been on the unemployment benefit for 12 months. It is easy, as our colleague Jacinda Ardern said, for both sides of the House to resort to stereotypes and throwaway insults. I really don't believe that it's got very much to do to what level of the continuum of politics or ideology that side of the House wants to throw out. My view, and I come from a community which every day experiences the consequences of state dependency, and they are not pretty consequences. And I do not wish that to be the lifelong legacy for my relations who live in those communities. So I stand here speaking authoritatively on this bill and knowing how important it is for people who are dependent on the state to have the opportunity, to have the encouragement, to have the support of a state who cares about... only I can speak about my experience, Carmel Cipollone, and I am the most authoritative on my experience, contrary to that member's view of her omniscience about everybody else's experience.
Sorry to interrupt the member. The member cannot continually interject if they're not in their own seat. Hege Parata.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. So, as I say, I can speak from my personal experience, and I do speak from my personal experience, and I absolutely support the provisions in this bill because I think that they give greater hope than would otherwise be the case. We are a caring and compassionate government. We are prepared to support people who need the support. We are... Oh, look, it's so easy to sit across there and throw insults when actually all that side of the House did was contribute and consign people to lifelong dependency because of the saviour complex that side of the House has suffered under for so long. Unlike that side of the House, actually, we embrace and celebrate people having the opportunity to make decisions for themselves about themselves. And what this policy and what this bill does is facilitate people to do that. I'm conscious that my time is running out, but what I want to say before I sit down is that I want to particularly thank the officials. The officials have had to answer very detailed questions from all members of our select committee and have done so assiduously, providing us with information that's allowed us to make what I think are very good decisions and that have resulted in a bill that before this House will help bring about the sea change that we need in New Zealand in order that the culture of aspiration that this government is committed to can be shared in by all New Zealanders. I commend this bill, Mr. Speaker.
I'll put the questions, and the first one is that the question to the amendments recommended by the Social Services Committee by majority be agreed to. Those of that opinion will say aye.
Aye.
Contrary, no.
No.
The ayes have it. Party vote.
Aye.
Clerk will conduct a party vote.
New Zealand National.
58 votes in favour.
New Zealand Labour.
42 votes opposed.
Green Party.
9 votes opposed.
ACT New Zealand.
4 in favour.
Māori Party.
He pōti whakawehewehe, tahi e tautokuana, toko toru e whakaheana.
Progressive.
1 opposed.
United Future.
1 vote in favour.
Any other votes?
The ayes are 64, the noes are 55. The amendments are agreed to. The question now is that the motion be agreed to. Those of that opinion will say aye.
Aye.
Contrary, no. The ayes have it. Party vote. The clerk will conduct a party vote.
New Zealand National.
58 votes in favour.
New Zealand Labour.
42 votes opposed.
Green Party.
9 votes opposed.
ACT New Zealand.
4 votes in favour.
Māori Party.
He pōti whakawehe ko tētahi e tautoko ana, toko toru e whakahe ana.
Progressive.
1 vote opposed.
United Future.
1 vote in favour.
Any other votes?